Hi, Susanne. Thank you so much for joining us today, or for joining me, I should say. It's brilliant to have you here. I'm really excited to share your story because we've known each other for a long time now. Too long.
Absolutely. No, never too long.
Never too long. Just shows how old we've become in the meantime. But we've known each other since our early 20s. Where we used to work together in a big multinational. I think we both had pretty good careers, didn't we? At the time we really enjoyed. And obviously I've moved on since then, and a few years later you moved on. So we might just jump straight into that, if you're okay with that, what you were doing and what led you to want to change it.
Yeah, no, thanks for having me, Yeshim, and letting me talk about the journey. I started my career in a big international company, and I was lucky enough to do lots of different roles there. Overall, I was there for about 15 years in multiple different roles and in different divisions of the company as well, which was great. And then in 2019, I decided to leave. I had wanted to leave for a long time before that. It was just a matter of finding the right time and going through the process of being ready and comfortable with leaving.
So
I left there, resigned, because it was very obvious that I had an amazing career there. I absolutely loved the career I'd had there. I had so many challenging roles. I got to travel the world, work with some great people, but I didn't find it interesting anymore. It wasn't what I wanted to do for the rest of my professional life. And I also felt I'd done the jobs I could do. I know I still had a lot to learn, but they couldn't really offer what I wanted to learn, so to speak.
Yeah.
And I couldn't see myself spending the rest of my professional life in front of a laptop. I just couldn't do that. So somehow I needed to move on to something, not entirely knowing what that was. So in mid-2019, I decided to leave and I resigned.
And so talk us through that. Did you have a plan before you resigned, or was it a spur of the moment thing? How did it come about?
No, I'd been thinking about it for a long time. I had my son in 2016, and even before I had him, I wanted to leave, but I also knew practically, financially, it made sense to just wait till I had him and, you know, just get to grips with motherhood for a few years, which I did. But then you also realize the desire is still there to do something else, and you can't just keep putting it off. So it wasn't a spur of the moment, but, you know, I had been planning it. But it was a bit, now I'm going to do it, and I'm going to do it now. And then it still feels a bit like a spur of the moment. You resign, you're like, oh my God, I've resigned. I didn't have a plan 100% because I found it really difficult to find out what I wanted to do next while I was still in a corporate full-on job.
What was your job before you? I know you did lots of different jobs.
Yes.
In the company. What was your role just before?
My last role was in a bid and quote capacity, helping with quoting big contracts effectively, mm-hmm. and putting the bids together.
Yeah.
And before that, I'd done business development. But I found it really difficult to find out what I wanted to do next, because they're quite full on. And you know, once you're done with your job and then having to think about what I wanted to do. So I had a plan. Well, my plan wasn't that much of a plan. I had a plan to take off. I think I'd set aside at least 4 months to find out what I wanted to do. I had started looking a little bit, but I also decided to take the summer off, basically, and to find out what I wanted to do. And initially, I talked to an agency about going into some kind of office-based roles, but slightly different roles, and more, you know, into training, supporting people who run training courses and getting into that. But I just wasn't very excited about going back into an office. That just didn't excite me.
Mm-hmm.
And then I came across a job at a college working, supporting young people there in a facilitating role. And I worked with young people before. I mentored for the Prince's Trust. And it kind of, there was something in that role that just sparked me. And I thought, actually, that's what I want to do. I want to, you know, I know it sounds like a cliche, I want to work with people. But actually, I did want to work with people, and I did enjoy, as much as they can be challenging young people, I did enjoy working with them. So I took on, well, I applied for the job at the end of 2019 and got the job, which was great. Job wasn't quite what I was looking for, which was a bit tough, to be honest, because I'd made this change, thought I'd found a new path. Wasn't quite the new path I'd expected it to be. In a way, lockdown and COVID helped me, because then I was kind of, I couldn't go into the college and do my role. So I had some time off again to think about what I wanted to do. And the good thing about working in a college is it was very clear to me I did want to work with young people, but also I was really interested in the teaching side, I found out. So I applied for a job at a sixth form college teaching business, and they offered me the job, and I started there in September 2020.
Amazing. And you've been doing that ever since, right?
Yeah, so I'm into my third year now. So so that's one of the things I've gone on to do. And then also working a bit in property development on the side. So I've kind of got kind of two hats on, so to speak. But that's my main profession now.
Amazing. So thinking back to your days when you were, you know, in this am I allowed to say comfortable corporate role? Mm-hmm. Can you remember what your biggest fear was around ultimately leaving there?
Yeah, well, no doubt one of them was, you know, the money. You get comfortable. I was on an extremely good package, and that is tied up in your whole identity. You don't have to worry about money. You are supporting your family really well. You don't have to worry about the future. And you are a person who are respected for your knowledge, your experience. You're the person people go to, you know, you are adding value on a daily basis. And that is tough not to have all of a sudden, because that is who you are as a person a lot of the time. Yeah. And that was probably my biggest fear. And also my fear was I didn't have a plan, and a lot of people didn't understand why I would leave such a comfortable, very well-paid job. And those people who don't understand it, your fears, they kind of, well, we told you shouldn't have done it. So you kind of like, those were my fears. But at the same time, I also knew, no, I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna show you it's the right thing I've done. So
you had people in your life that thought you were completely bonkers. And then did you also, this is a leading question, but did you then also have people that were sort of cheerleading you from the side as well?
Yeah, absolutely. So I had in my kind of cheerleading support corner, I had my husband. He was very supportive, despite knowing this was going to have an impact on him and our family as well. But he'd also seen that this wasn't something I've just come up with.
Yeah.
We've been talking about it for a number of years. Mm-hmm. And then I had a really good friend of mine who was very supportive and asking the right questions in a challenging way, but also in a very supportive way. Mm-hmm. So they were in my corner, and you don't need more than just a few people, really, but as long as they're the right people. Mm-hmm. And I had plenty of people, I wouldn't say they'd said it to my face, I was crazy, but they definitely thought it. Family, friends, wasn't quite sure. And what I would do sometimes, in a way, it didn't matter to me what they thought. You know, that's no disrespect to them, but I was still going to do it. But what I would do sometimes, once I'd made the decision and I had decided to do it, I would sometimes talk to them about what I was doing. Or when I first resigned, I would sometimes tell them about it, and they would then challenge me and ask me why I've done it, and I would justify it. Well, not justify it, I would explain why I've done it, and so on. And it kind of gave me a bit of a boost to do that, because they kind of convinced, I was like, yeah, that's why I've done it. Actually, if I kind of reconvinced myself, or in a way. So I also found them when people challenged me, it wasn't necessarily a bad thing. Probably because I was very comfortable with my decision, and because I did it at a time where I'd made the decision and I thought I could make it work. I think you need to be careful to do that too early on. If you're still unsure about what you're going to do, you need to do it at the right time. But it definitely worked for me sometimes to talk to people who would challenge me.
Yeah, absolutely. So was that one of the ways you overcame any fears that you had around leaving your job?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Because when you talk about it, because one of the things I remember, my good friend asked, what's the worst thing that can happen? And then you sit down and think, well, the very worst thing is I have to knock the door again at that corporate job and ask if they could take me back. Now I'm going to have to swallow my pride. That's like the worst. That is so bad.
Yeah.
Or the second worst thing would be I would have to find a similar job and apply for it, and I might be successful in getting it.
Yeah.
And when you talk that out loud and say that, and that is your biggest fear in life right now, and think about, is that the worst thing that could happen to me? It actually sounds a little bit silly.
Yeah.
If you think about it. And it was sometimes talking through that kind of made me thought, well, that's not a real fear, right? So you kind of have the fear and you knock it, and well, okay, what's left then?
Yes.
And yeah, that's probably one of the things that helped me overcome it. Also, eventually you're going to have to start voicing to people what you're doing, and that slowly starts breaking down the fears, I think.
Yeah, that makes complete sense. I think just talking it through,
yeah,
every time you talk it through, you hopefully come closer to down those barriers. And I mean, it's been a hell of a journey, right? Because, you know, it's been a complete life change for you. What is it that you feel you've learned about yourself in this process?
Well, I've learned that the skills I've acquired throughout my career, I've been able to put at really good use somewhere else.
Yeah.
And also, I'll be completely honest, going into teaching, I know a lot about business. That's not been the problem to teach that. But teaching, I knew nothing about. And there's so much more to it than I thought. And it was such a steep learning curve the first year. Oh, my God. I had days where I thought, I hardly get paid anything. I'm working so much, and I was doing a qualification as well at the same time. Mm-hmm. I'm not entirely sure why I'm doing this sometimes, because it just seems to have complicated my life a bit. But then you realize how quick you are at learning and picking up things. So I need a bit of time to start with, you're just trying to figure out how this world works now and get into it. But I have learned that I am very quick, because you have that knowledge and experience in the bag. You can very quickly pick up something new. And I've always wanted to be a person who can be put into a situation and then pick something new up. I think that really says a lot about a person. Mm-hmm. Anybody can do the same job for 20 years and do it really well. Mm-hmm. But can you be faced with a new challenge and quite quickly figure out how to deal with that and become really good at it?
Yeah.
And I've also realized if I decide I want to do something, I want to be good, but also we want to be one of the best at it, then I can do that.
If you put your mind to it, right? Yeah,
absolutely. And I don't do things half-hearted. I wanted to do the teaching thing. I've done it 100%. I want to get to grips with it. I want to find out how to do it well.
Yeah.
And slowly getting there, I think. So
I love that about you, Susanne. You know, look, just grab the ball by the horns and go for it.
Yeah. No, and I have been, and I must admit, I was also really surprised how focused, when I was doing my teaching qualification, it was hard work and a lot of assignments, I had to set time aside and had to sell the family sometimes, right, you guys just have to leave the house and leave me to it. But the focus I've had was actually really nice to feel that again, because I haven't had that since I went to university. Mm-hmm. And that's a long time ago. And it's like, oh my God, brain is still ticking the right way and quick enough to do that. And that was really nice to experience as well.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, you have a lot to give. We're not disputing that ever.
We'll see, hopefully.
You know, you talked about the fact that you had this career and it was, you know, you were going into different jobs within the same slightly different.
Yeah.
I guess you were getting promoted along the way.
Yeah.
And by anybody's definition, you had a successful career, right? And yet you knew there was something within you that, you know, you wanted that change. So I'm just curious to know now, you know, having experienced, you know, the successful career and, you know, undoubtedly you're really good at what you're doing now as well. But I'm just curious to know what your definition of success is now, today.
Yeah, I think in terms of personal success for me, what it is for me now is having flexibility.
Mm-hmm.
So being able to be flexible around when I work and how I work. I know I'm a teacher, so I have to adhere to certain timetables, of course, but I've got school holidays off, for example. I work part-time doing extra hours whenever I want. I do my preparation whenever I want. We fit around the other side of the business I'm involved with as well. So flexibility is key, and I will never do a job again that does not give me that flexibility.
Yeah, amazing.
And then I think the other thing success for me is, and especially as I'm getting older, is being able to take something new and figure it out and get good at it.
Mm.
And I'm already now thinking, right, once I've done my third year, I've taught most of the curriculum. What do I do next now? Because I don't want to sit back. No, I can have a very comfortable life the next 10 years and just teaching the same. What do I do next now? What do I teach next? What do I go on to next? And so forth. Because I think for me, success is being really good at something in one area and taking what you learn from that and then being really good at something in another area, using those skills and experience. That's success for me. If I look at people I admire, it's people who, you know, do something different on a regular basis and are really good. It doesn't really matter what they do. It's being good, and they're so good at so many things. That's what I'm quite inspired with, and what the person I would like to be.
So yeah, I love that. So yeah. Can we talk about money? Because I think for a lot of people, they define their success by how much money they're making. And I know that, you know, obviously you were earning a really decent salary. I know your husband was earning a decent salary, and he made some changes as well. How have your thoughts around money changed over the last 2 or 3 years?
Yeah, the thing was, I remember we had this conversation, and I do believe I remember thinking, because I earned a lot of money, I had a very good salary, and I spent a lot, and I really started to feel uncomfortable about that.
Mm-hmm.
So I saw it as an opportunity. I went from, you know, literally I ended up with a salary initially when I'd left my corporate job that where I got paid the same as my car allowance used to be.
Mm.
So that's the level we're talking, you know, it went down, and it went completely down. And you know what? It was such a great experience to find out once I had that extra time in my life, I wasn't as stressed. I wasn't as running 100 miles an hour sometimes. I didn't have that need to treat myself and compensate for that all the time. I also, it was a bit like a cold turkey that you just go in and you basically had very little money. Of course, we had some savings to help tie us over because you still had to pay the bills.
Sure.
But I went to the extreme all the way down and then slowly started building up again. But I have found we can live on very little compared to what we used to do. And also just don't have that quite, I think knowing that I used to earn that amount of money and I can go back in and doing it is enough for me. I never feel I want to compete with people because I've been there, done that. I can do that too. I think the choosing not to gives me more power. It's very empowering in a way. I feel I'm more in control of, well, I don't feel money controls me as they used to do, where I'm controlling them, if that makes sense.
Yeah, it makes complete sense.
Of course, having had a corporate career and having had some savings in the bank and also have a pension and everything makes it a bit easier to have that attitude. I'm fully aware of that. But I do think it's a matter of taking the control over it rather than the other way around. So I don't assess myself. I don't really care what I earn.
Do you think your 25-year-old self would be shocked to hear you say this right now?
Yeah, probably. And also, you know, I spent 5 years in university and I'm thinking, okay, after 15 years, I decided to just like pack it in. Well, you never do. And that's what you have to remember. Whatever you do today leads on to what you're going to do tomorrow. So yeah. I would never have ended up where I'm in now if I hadn't done what I've done previously. And I will never trade my corporate career for anything.
Yeah.
I'm so grateful for having had that and that opportunity. So
yeah. Because I guess also because of the subject that you're teaching now, which is business.
Well, exactly. I'm absolutely.
I couldn't have a completely different perspective than.
Yeah, somebody. Absolutely. And also I'm working now with young people at the college who are looking to start their own business. That is probably, if I look next step, I want to get more involved in that side as well. And there's some initiatives going on at the college I'm looking to get more involved in. So, you know, this is a platform. And then, you know, there's definitely a few more things I've got I want to do around that. So
very exciting, exciting times.
Absolutely.
And for anybody that's listening to this, what would your advice be? Having been through this journey, and you're still on this journey, right? It's never...
Yeah.
You know, yeah. I'm going to stop this and start that. You know, it is an evolving thing. Life is an evolving thing.
Absolutely.
What would your advice be to somebody that's in a job where, you know, they're really thinking it's time for me to make a change for whatever reason that might be? What would your wise words be?
I think I would say don't do it too soon, as in, I think it's a process you have to go through. And when big changes happen in life, you need to be ready and comfortable with them. And if you do it too soon, you may not be quite ready for it. I think if you're 100% ready, then it makes that transition easier and also quicker. You're quicker at moving on to the next thing because you work through emotionally, you work through it as well. And you can also deal with those challenges a lot more, a lot better, so to speak. Yeah. So I took a long time, I'll be honest, but it doesn't matter. I wasn't in a hurry. If you look back, you have to sometimes not be in a hurry. But at the same time, I would also say, do it. We rarely regret the things we do. We only regret the things we don't do. And that still sticks in my mind that year. I remember reading that quote and I thought, no, actually, that's true. Again, back to what's the worst thing that can happen if this doesn't work. I would also say don't get completely paralyzed and not do anything. Have a bit of a plan, because, and when I say plan, it's just that once you quit and all of a sudden you've got this time on your hand, quite quickly the pressure will feel they're starting to build. Like, what are you going to do now? Like, come up with a plan. What are you going to move on to? Just figure a little bit out. What are you going to do the first few weeks? What are you going to do the first months, the few months? Just have a little bit and have somebody in your corner you can meet with on a regular basis and talk to. Because I think we underestimate that shift from being your whole identity wrapped up in that job, knowing exactly what you're going to do in the morning when you get up. And then all of a sudden you're on your own, and it can be quite lonely.
Mm.
So I think having a little bit of a plan how you're going to manage your time once if you do quit without something to move on to immediately.
Yeah.
That's probably
that accountability, isn't it? I think when we're we've been in a job for a long time, we have people that are holding us accountable, you know, the boss, the team, the shareholders, you know, whoever it might be. And I think there is that void when you step away from that.
Yeah.
Time out. There's nobody. Yeah. What's going on? Why aren't we meeting deadlines? Or
no, absolutely. And it's just a gentle nudging and having somebody to meet up with, and you can talk to about it, whether that's your partner or a friend or, you know, somebody in your professional network, whatever that is. I think that's important.
That's really great advice. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Is there anything else that you wish I'd asked you, or something else that you would really love to share with people?
No, I think
let you go.
I think that's it. I would say, move a little bit closer to that step where you make the final step. If you're not just there yet, that's fine. Just every day move a little bit closer to it.
Amazing. Thank you so, so much.
It's okay.
I'm really grateful that you've taken the time to share your story. And on a personal note, I look forward to seeing how your career continues to evolve. It's really fun to watch.
Thank you, Yashim. No, it's been lovely talking to you.
All right. Take care.
Bye. Take care. Bye. Bye.